faster.
Greetings.
Chasing that witches make you go gray.
Mountains out of molehills, Villanelle.
Heard you calling. Wanted to talk?
I did, for we're neck deep in trouble. Of the spider kind.
Need a maid with a broom, not a witcher.
You fail to understand. These are huge. The size of pigs or dogs. Black and hairy, spewing webs.
Not talking about spiders then. Talking about arachnomorphs.
Call them what you will. You must smash the rogues, will you? Those caves would be prime barrel storage were it not for the beasts.
First things first. Need to talk about my reward.
Not an amount I can afford. I knew we would agree terms.
Arachnomorphs don't look much like bunnies, but they sure breed like them. Best nip the problem in the bud. I'll look into it.
I wonder if I can get a loan from Chelfinet. And if I were to put up my wife.
Thank you.
my strength's gone.
Any tidings?
All taken care of. Went inside and cleaned up.
Thank the gods! And you too, of course.
I was looking to buy something. Maybe sell something too. Time I got back on the path. So long.
Thank you.
Lads, I find your concern touching, I do. Yet I've long awaited this day. So, you must forgive me, but I shall go through with it as planned. Ah, it seems my guide has arrived.
Greetings.
Greetings to you, White Wolf. I presume you saw my notice? Foolish question. You're here, thus you must have seen it. Forgive me, I should introduce myself. Count Belladal, a great admirer of your deeds.
Thanks. Not something we witchers hear often.
But Count, sir, do you mean to go off with just this witcher? A right hardy fellow he is, no ponce, I'm sure. But your expedition's too risky on the whole. And not taking us with you's, pardon my saying it, right daft.
You exaggerate, Vilmar. I believe I can manage to survive half a day without someone there to wipe me arse in my stead. My guards lament, witcher, but you must forgive them. Now, to get down to brass tacks. As you've no doubt gleaned from the notice, I've a rather extraordinary proposition for you. I'm a lover, witcher, of nature. A devotee of the wild. And Toussaint is home to several species not encountered elsewhere. I'd like you to accompany me on an expedition whose aim is to... preserve them. Ah, yes. Naturally, you'll protect me should the need arise. My ever-vigilant guards, see, will report any reckless behaviour to my wife if I get so much as a scratch. And then woe will be me.
Count Belladal? Famous poultry farmer, is that it?
Well, that was my grandpapa. Dear man. But my trade is the wine trade. I import the finest vintages to Cavir, my homeland. The very reason for my frequent visits to Beauclair, during which I like to, partake of nature, let us say.
Really need a witcher to, partake? Got guards of your own. Take them, save some coin.
I could, surely. But they too deserve a bit of rest, relaxation. Right, lads? Besides, I've plenty of coin. Coin that needs spending. Who dares stop me?
Ah. So this is about a rich man, bored stiff, seeking thrills.
There's also Clarissa, who...
Vilmar, please.
Who what?
My daughter. I always return from my travels with some souvenir or another. She looks forward to them tremendously. But we did not meet to chat about my family. We must discuss our venture, must we not?
Need some details before I can say anything. Where are we going? What am I supposed to do exactly?
In the roundest terms, we shall admire the local flora and fauna. And while we do, I might preserve a thing or two.
Preserve?
Of this device, see? A peristysomach. It captures, likenesses.
A peristysomach what?
It's like a movable megascope, capturing moments, transforming them into illusions, based upon which I then paint a painting.
So, you want me with you, looking at animals and flowers and...
Well, that's more or less what it amounts to, yes. Except you will first have to track down the creatures I wish to capture. I know only the very approximate locations of their habitats. Well, and should any trouble arise... will have your sword at the ready, right? So, agreed?
Doesn't seem hard. Be glad to do something pleasant for a change.
Sublime. In that case, here's your map. Before coming here, I dispatched requests to several local hunters. They located the habitats of the species of interest to me and marked out their ranges on the map.
Good. It'll save us some time. Won't need to track. Ready to go?
Yes, let's. The light seems perfect just now.
Blake, give me a drink.
Dawn's superior light.
Seems I got the map, so I'll lead. Wouldn't rather be out here with those guards of yours?
You jest. It's deliverance to emerge from under their wings, believe me. They're overprotective, oppressively so. I wish to admire the wildlife, preserve it. Not watch them kill it in a fit of misguided fear for my life.
What if the wildlife attacks us?
Then we shall have no other recourse. I do not...
Map says there should be panthers around here. Stay close. Keep your eyes peeled. Something like a bear.
One request, Witcher. Avoid bloodshed, if at all possible.
That? Deer, I think.
Incredible. Sharp as a razor, you're hearing.
Hear that? Panthers.
Frankly, I did not hear a thing. Clearly, your senses are far more acute than mine. I must rely on them.
Snares. Looks like they were hoping for a bear. Panther got caught instead.
Look, Cole. Can you help Mother?
Give it a shot. I'm going at first. More likely to budge this otherwise.
Folk call witches heartless. This will put the lie to that.
Peristysomax upset the animals. Better get out of here.
Cannot abide poaching. Content you share my love for animals.
Got pretty broad interests for a man of the city.
I suppose I dabble in my share of things. Wine, nature, painting. I imagine the life of a witcher must be rather more monotonous. With all due respect.
It is. Never boring, though.
I, for one, cannot fathom only ever consorting with the same creatures, day in and day out.
Got a wife? See that? Soil's been turned over recently. Smells of fresh peat, too. Shh. Hear him?
It's those...
Centipedes. Giant. Underground tunnel burrowers. Make a distinct sound. He can use that to track them. Sounds loud and clear here. Must be near the nest. We're here.
Well, this vantage point's no good. We shan't capture a good image from here.
All right, wait. We'll find you a better spot that's safe, too. Tread lightly. Giant centipede sends the softest sounds, the lightest vibrations. You wake one up, it wakes up angry. here, maybe. Distance seems right. Light's not bad either.
Yes, this will work perfectly.
Can you lure them out?
Give me a minute. Need to think. Vibrations. Gotta send some through the ground. I'll try tossing a bomb or casting a sign. And you watch out. Don't get any closer.
Excellent day for capturing moments. Truly magnificent. We can move on now. Exhilarating. Positively exhilarating. Thank you. I've one more request. Local peacocks performing their mating ritual. I'd love to see that. Apparently, a flock dwells not far from here.
We can go. Just don't count on peeping at them while they mate. Season ended a month back.
Oh, that's terrible. I so wish to capture their splendorous tails in full bloom. Is there nothing you can do if they prove uneager to present? Perhaps challenge them somehow? Goad them?
What did you have in mind? Don't have a tail myself, and I'm not likely to sprout one anytime soon.
My thoughts were more along the lines of Witcher magic. They say you can exert influence over lesser creatures.
Yeah, guess I can try. Can't promise you anything, though.
Splendid. Consider me contented. I cannot pinpoint the flock's location, but a hunter I know told me a few likely spots. I'll mark them for you.
All right. Let's go find some peacocks. Wondering. Why peacocks?
My daughter is rather fond of them. They will be a treat for her.
We're close. Eyes in the back of your head. Feather from the rump, coated in suet. Cock shed it recently and the suet's got a distinct scent. Ought to be able to track the flock.
A witcher in action. What a treat to watch.
Shh. Hear that? They're calling to each other.
Fabulous. We're getting close. Just splay the tails.
See what I can do. Find a good spot.
Ready? Use your magic, Witcher!
This'll be a masterpiece!
Smile, please!
Giant centipedes. Damn it.
Where did they come from?
Must have followed us. Get back.
Get him! Save me!
Whew, that was tense. I believe I've had my fill of excitement for today. What a wonderful adventure.
Get everything you wanted?
Yes.
In that case, time to get back to your camp. Returning your lord to you, safe and sound.
You've our gratitude, Master.
You see, lads, there was nothing to fear.
Thank you, Witcher, for looking after our dear count. Seems the jaunt did him wonders. Breathed some new life into him.
Wait here a moment, Geralt. I have to fetch my coin pouch. Pay my dues.
I'm not your boss. No need to kiss up to me.
You've read us all wrong. Count Belladal's a bit odd, aye, but a better man to serve I cannot imagine. What he does for his daughter, well, speaks for itself.
His daughter?
Made no mention, did he? 10 years back, his last, Clarice is her name, took a spill off her horse. Been bedridden ever since. Cannot walk of her own. She'd been the life of the house before the calamity. A merry sprite what filled every corner with joy. Count would oft take her out on trips. She loved animals too. Excursions he makes now, or rather, paintings he brings home. They's her only window on the wider world.
Sorry to make you wait. I was dead chuffed to be able to observe you in action, to confirm for myself there that the tales about you were not exaggerated in the slightest. You show discipline, reliability, responsibility. I dare say you'd make the ideal business associate. That's a shame you've no interest in the wine trade.
One day, maybe.
Your reward. Use it well.
Thanks.
I've one other matter I wish to broach. In a few days' time, I shall exhibit my work for some friends, my coterie, so to speak. Would you come by?
Why not, if I'm in the area?
Splendid. In that case, I shall see you at my lodgings. I'm staying with a friend while in Tucson, near a village named Francolar.
I'll be by. See ya.
The gods partook of their vileness, Sven. Boars everywhere.
Run, Roach.
You, hey, with the blades out, help us! Monsters on the road.
Up if I want to get rid of the Endriggers.
Why do you stick around here? Like a pitchfork in a dung
pile.
What's going on there?
Master Witcher, welcome. Count Belladagos.
It's greasy. Blood on his jacket. What's wrong?
Awaits in the courtyard with the other guests.
The wilds of Tucson harbor innumerable.
Greetings and.
Both male and female Beauclair centipedes are formidable predators. The beasts prefer to hunt in packs. Yet the author of this extraordinary work is able to capture a lone specimen preparing to attack. Cast your eye on the hunter, who, though fully aware of the danger, wears a look of cold determination on his face as he awaits the optimal moment to strike.
Ah, Geralt, you're here. Wonderful. Come, please.
I'm delighted to see you. I have a small gift for you, and I shan't let you refuse.
Thanks. Talked to your guards back at the camp. Told me about Clarissa. Sorry to hear about her accident.
Thank you. Kind words that mean a great deal to me.
How's Clarissa these days? Probably can't wait for you to get back.
To get her gifts, you mean? I've dispatched two already. She'll not need to wait for my return.
En route home, I mean to pass through Dol Blathana. They say one can see Sylvans there.
Yeah, actually happen to know one. Name's Torque. He can be mean, but for the right fee, he'll do anything you ask.
Splendid. I thank you for the hint.
Tell him I send my regards. Good crowd. You got a lot of friends. All of them seem to be fawning over your paintings, too.
Oh, when you have as much coin as I do, friends buzz around like flies on fresh meat. And they praise you to high heavens for each trip, burp and sneeze. Not all are lying sycophants, that's not what I mean. Just most, unfortunately.
Why bother? Why even invite them around?
I'm a man of enterprise. I must put my trade before any personal hatreds or sympathies. Besides? At times, I'll exhibit a completely failed painting just to listen to them twist their tongues into knots, trying to find just the right superlatives to lather on smeared rubbish. Naturally, the more intent someone is to get into my good graces, the louder they praise my masterpiece. It's devilish fun, I tell you.
Nice meeting you. So long now.
Regis!
Damn it. Locked. No way I got the place wrong. This is it. Gotta be another way in around here. Some stench. agreed to meet a vampire at a cemetery. How much more cliché can you get?
Nothing comes readily to mind.
Could have left the door unlatched.
What of my privacy? I value it rather deeply. Unmolested, especially by unwanted guests, that's my preferred state. Besides, I knew you'd find a way to get in.
True enough. Need to find your friend. I'm hoping you'll agree to help.
I shall do whatever's in my power. Yet what you want or even need must matter little. What matters is what Detlaf wants. If he does not wish to be found, you will not find him. Ever. End of story.
Come on. Gotta be some way.
Vampires can evade detection by the senses, and no divination magic works on us. Even the most precise magoscope would be useless.
And this? Could this help?
Wherever did you get that?
Off one of the beast's victims, found by a bend in the river. Body was chopped in pieces. Three of those pieces were hands. Hand with the ring seemed the odd one out. Abruxa had taken an interest in it.
It's Detlaf's hand, without a doubt. It will do splendidly.
Ring's pretty intriguing. Made of no metal I've ever seen. And the ornamentation.
It comes from our home. Where we lived before the conjunction of spheres. It's actually mine. I received it from a dear old friend. You might call him a humanist. He saw us vampires as guests here. Guests who owe their hosts, meaning you humans and the elder races, respect.
Respect? Meaning not to treat us like cattle to be slaughtered for food?
Precisely. And the reason why I in turn gave it to Detlaf. To remind him of the ideals my old friend championed.
Can't you just summon Detlaf? You're both hired vampires, there's gotta be a way.
If I'm to be entirely candid, there is indeed one. But believe me, we will be better off never availing ourselves of it. It is a last resort. Absolutely.
Last resort? The hell. Why?
There is a being who can summon Detlaf. Possesses the authority, even the power, to force him to appear in a given place. But the very act of contacting this being... well, it's akin to walking a slack line extended over a chasm filled with molten lava. An exercise as perilous to me as it would be to you. A risk I'm unwilling to take. I beg you, let's do it my way. It will be both quicker and easier.
The hand. What do you plan to do with it?
You've heard of Kobinares' theory of tissue memory retention.
Rings a distant bell. Read about it in Alchemia Obliterata. There's a copy of Kaer Morhen, tattered, nearly disintegrated. But if memory serves, Kobinares never managed to prove it worked.
He did prove it. Just never managed to publish his findings. He and I corresponded, you see, after we became friends. Thus, I know he completed his research and performed the first tests. It's complicated, so without delving into details, it is possible to use any piece of tissue to reconstruct what a whole body experienced.
How's it work? We need any special equipment?
We must brew a decoction which Kobinares gave a rather poetic name, Resonance. Once imbibed, it sends one into a trance similar to that induced by narcotics. This triggers visions of events linked to strong emotions experienced by the tissue's owner. Picture it as dreaming a fragment of someone's life.
Any chance we might see what Detlaf was doing just before he lost his hand?
Indeed. Though I also hope Resonance will reveal the location of Detlaf's hideout.
Kovenarius spent half his life proving his theory. Wild guess. Making a dose of resonance won't be easy.
You guess correctly. In addition to Detlaf's tissue, we shall need a powerful occipital lobe stimulant. Effectively a poison, to make one susceptible to visions.
Well, got a few ingredients to choose from. Unfortunately, all are pretty rare. There's Mamoon glands. The closest ones I know of are in Vizima. A spotted white saliva would also serve, but they were culled to extinction over a century ago. Could go with a kobold's eyes, but the creatures are sentient. Rather not gouge one's eyes out.
Hmm. Given that we lack the time to sleuth this out ourselves, permit me to summon some help.
What was that?
A raven? Rather a common sight at this latitude. Very intelligent fowl. I asked him to look for the creatures you mentioned. Him and his brethren. Perhaps they'll find one in the area, and I would hazard that a flock of ravens will spy any said creature faster than a solitary witcher would. With all due respect to your skills, my friend. It will take them some time, nonetheless. So, perhaps you'd care for a snifter of mandrake.
Rarely say no to a snifter.
Sadly, this is but a weak infusion rather than a proper distillate.
Even better. I remember your mandrake hooch. Made people say things they'd have rather kept to themselves.
Now, what could Geralt of Rivia prefer to keep to himself?
Everyone's got some secret.
I agree wholeheartedly. I also believe it wise at times to share one's secrets, unburden oneself to those one can trust.
This your sophisticated way of asking me if I trust you?
I prefer almost always to ask indirectly. It seems a test of intelligence, one you just passed.
Maybe you should go first. Reveal one of your secrets. After all, you vampires lead very interesting lives.
Anything in particular interest you?
Curious what you did after you were reborn.
As I'm sure you can surmise, at first I was thoroughly absorbed with recovering. As it is, I've still not recovered completely. Yet I was so weak the first year that I could not stand nor move on my own. Detlaf bore my weakness bravely, showed great patience. If not for him, I wouldn't be here, and I'd have regenerated far slower. Once I could at last stand unassisted, I set off for Bruges, for my one-time home of Dillingen. There I led the peaceful life of a rural healer and surgeon, enjoying my neighbour's respect and, in fact, constituting the exact opposite of the monstrous vampire the populace imagines.
Bruges, you say? Rebirth make you sentimental?
Perhaps, a dash. But what of you? Where have you been? Ever find your Cirilla?
Back then, yeah. But we parted again soon after. Gotta ask you the big question, one everyone wonders about. What happens after death?
You wish me to tell you if the human belief in the gods is well-founded? Well, that I do not know. We vampires differ exceedingly from you humans. Our matter, that of which we are composed, can exist without form. We require neither a heart, nor a brain, nor air to breathe.
But were you dead?
As humans understand death, yes.
Feel anything? Understand anything?
It's rather hard to explain. I felt something very unsettling. Something I cannot even name, for I did no reasoning. Only after rebirth did I begin to understand that what I had felt was cold and unimaginable fear. If not for Detlaf, I might have drowned in an eternity of icy terror.
Can't have been alive then. Sheesh, experience like that must be vicious.
Indeed, it's hard to compare to anything I know. Yet you are aware we don't see death as you do. The way you cling to life, we find it entirely peculiar. You are mortals, ergo it's a foregone conclusion. You will die. It's but a question of time. Thus, I often find myself wondering why you try so very hard. To die at 20 years, 40, even 100, what's the difference? They're all but the blink of an eye.
Depends on your point of view. Man who's got 1,000,000 crowns to spend can't possibly understand one who's only got 20.
Very true. One's outlook can indeed change much.
Got a new life, new body. That give you a new start, blank slate?
Starting all anew is a very broad concept. What exactly do you mean?
Your blood addiction, say. Wondering if your body's the same, if it still remembers. Maybe if you drank now, you wouldn't get hooked.
All addictions are a form of slavery. Re-addiction's not a risk I'm willing to take, just to test a hypothesis about corporeal regeneration and whether propensities carry over.
Fair enough. Curiosity, that's all. Sorry.
Not to worry, Geralt. Curiosity's a natural reaction under the circumstances, apart from which I've always valued that trait in you.
Always fascinated me the way vampires can regenerate. A hand growing back is one thing, but Detlaf recreating you out of a wet smear? Something else entirely.
A difficult and laborious process, but one that's possible, as my presence proves. But I've heard you too had quite the adventure. They say you lost your memory.
For a bit, but Triss helped me get it back. Actually, pretty damn lucky I only had amnesia.
Yes, you humans are rather buggered in those terms. To strip you of life is, well, just plain easy. I've always pitied you in that regard. We vampires are much harder nuts to crack. If a member of another race kills one of us, we can be reborn with a living eye of vampire's help. However, if one of our own strikes the deadly blow, death is permanent. There can be no rebirth. One of the chief reasons why vampires long ago swore never to fight one another.
All right, give you one question. What do you want to know?
One question to ask one as fascinating as you, Geralt. Cruel parsimony, I'd say. But I shall do my best to make it count. If you were to die and be reborn as I was, in your new life, would you choose to be a Witcher?
See, Regis. Doubt I'd know how to be anything else.
Ever tried?
Seer determined to get an answer, to find out if I like being a Witcher. Just refused to ask directly, as always. I like being on the path. I like picking up a lead, a trail. I like the tension right before a fight. And nothing gets my adrenaline flowing like battling a beast. Even gotten used to people treating me like a freak, an outcast. Yeah, not something I think about much. But I like being a Witcher.
Thank you for being honest. Honesty is an attribute of the truly brave, and thus a privilege of the very few.
Still no sign of your winged friend. Sure it understood what you wanted?
Dead certain. Let's wait a bit longer. It'll return soon, don't doubt that for a moment. Ever vigilant, even in his sleep. Quite vampire-like, in fact. Are you absolutely certain they don't administer a few of our genes during the trial of the grasses?
Appreciate the compliment. Got something for me?
You were right. No kobolds or mamoons for miles around.
Knew it.
Allow me to finish. You see, there's this spotted white. It haunts an abandoned residence in the Caraberta Woods.
Impossible. My brethren hunted down every last spotted white before I was born.
Then it seems you must revise your knowledge of spotted whites. For somehow this one managed to survive your brethren's onslaught. It seems I know this home it haunts. Recall a tale about it. Locals believe the place cursed. Perhaps that's how the White survived entirely unmolested.
Whites rarely appear in the woods, even less likely to find them in abandoned human homes. They inhabit remote wildernesses, old abandoned cemeteries.
What's your point?
This might not be a spotted white after all. Your little helper might have made a mistake.
I sincerely doubt it. Ravens are devilishly intelligent creatures, and they've highly developed observational skills.
What exactly did they observe?
The area around the estate. It's covered in spoons.
Spoons?
Spare me the skeptical smile. I'm but the bearer of this news. Well, perhaps this spotted white is a hoarder. Or the spoons are somehow related to the curse.
Know anything else about this curse?
I don't recall much in particular. Really don't attach much importance to such things. It was mentioned to me as an anecdote, no more.
Come on, search your memory. Something, anything could be important.
I believe it had a relation to hunger, or perhaps greed, rapacity. Someone was punished for something.
Textbook definition of a curse, pretty much.
Sorry, Geralt, I try not to clutter my mind with the details of every far-fetched tale I happen to hear. What are your thoughts?
A specimen of a species thought long extinct, and a curse in one place. That a coincidence, or are they related?
Ah, professional curiosity. Personally, I've nothing against you delving into this dilemma, but please remember we need the White's saliva. Nothing beyond that.
Let's do this. Start making your decoction while I go get some saliva from that White. Uses it in its brews.
Do you imagine the White will simply sell you some?
Worst case scenario, I'll bring you its salivary glands. They ought to do as well.
For a moment there, I imagined you asking the White to spit into a vial. Quite amusing as a thought, but the salivary glands will do fine indeed.
So, see you later.
Yes, till later. I shall start by perusing some tomes.
Tomes? Thought you were going to make this decoction.
We require one last ingredient. Alas, obtaining it could prove a trifle toilsome. Thus, I hope to identify a suitable alternative.
All right. Good luck.
And to you, my friend.